Venezuela's main opposition leader, Juan Guaido, returned to his country today, a week after deadly clashes erupted over aid shipments delivered to his nation's borders. Today, thousands gathered in the streets of Caracas, the capital, to welcome home the man the U.S. considers the rightful president of Venezuela. Guaido says he'll continue his effort to unseat sitting president Nicolas Maduro. Nick Schifrin has this update.
Juan Guaido had kept details of his travel back into the country secret, fearing the Maduro government might arrest him. The U.S. had warned it would impose a, quote, strong and significant response if anything happened to him. But Guaido arrived safely in Caracas and urged his supporters to intensify their campaign against Maduro.
They threaten all of us here. They threaten me with jail and death. It will not be through persecution. It will not be through threats. They will hold us back. We are here, and we're more united than ever. We are here and are stronger than ever.
The U.S. has been supporting Guaido even before he declared himself interim president on January 23rd. But so far, Maduro has resisted pressure to step down and doesn't appear to be going anywhere. So what's next, and where does the opposition go from here? To talk about that, I'm joined by Carlos Vecchio, Guaido's representative here in Washington, who is recognized by the administration as the Venezuelan ambassador. Thank you very much for being on the NewsHour.
Thank you for having me.
So far, Maduro has resisted international diplomatic pressure, massive political protests in the streets, major sanctions, and an effort to force in humanitarian aid. So what can you realistically do to increase the pressure and oust Maduro?
Well, what we saw today, I mean, tells you that we're in the right path. I mean, we have a man of his word. He said and he promised to the people of Venezuela that he will return to Venezuela. He did it. And this, you know, makes us stronger. And I think the regime is weaker. And we need to increase all the pressure at the street levels with demonstration. We are calling for a new demonstration this coming Saturday. We will need to increase our pressure at the level of the National Assembly, which is the only elected institution in Venezuela, and also from the international community. And if we increase the level of pressure in these three different levels, I think we could find a peaceful solution in Venezuela. That's what we want.
If those three elements of pressure doesn't work, would you support a military intervention?
I would say that we want to work with these three different levels. Nobody wants a war. I mean, we have a war in place right now. Maduro has created a man-made disaster in Venezuela. We are having the consequence of having a war without war in a certain way. And he's trying to push to that scenario. And we need to avoid it. That's why we need to increase the pressure now. We have the opportunity to avoid a war right now. So we need to increase that pressure if we want to find a peaceful solution in Venezuela. But of course, I mean, all the action will be on the table. But the main obstacle for a peaceful solution in Venezuela is Maduro. That's why we need to increase the pressure now.
One of the points of pressure, of course, will be economic. The economy is expected to collapse even more than it already has in the coming months, thanks to U.S. sanctions. Do you fear that as that economic pressure increases, the people of Venezuela will be hurt even more before Maduro is ousted?
No, I would say that the worst sanction that Venezuela has is Maduro. All this, you know, disaster started a long way ago, even before the sanctions were imposed. So if Maduro continues in power, you will see a catastrophe in Venezuela. You will see more than 5 million people out of Venezuela. So that's why we need to stop that. It's enough. 20 years has been too much. We have a huge opportunity in front of us in order to recover our democracy. So the time to increase the pressure is now to avoid exactly what we are seeing right now in Venezuela. Maduro has imposed a 10% of inflation without having any sanctions from the U.S., any sanction. And Maduro has imposed 87% of poverty in Venezuela. The economic collapse is twice the size of the Great Depression that U.S. had during the 30s. So the problem is Maduro. If we want to resolve the humanitarian crisis in Venezuela, we need to recover our democracy. We need to end the usurpation of power of Maduro. And that's why we are pushing this pressure in Venezuela on the streets.
The military will be much of the linchpin here. A lot of people describe the military support of Maduro as really the only reason that he can maintain power. Have you had any talks directly with the military leadership?
We have been talking with them publicly. Juan Guaido is the new commander-in-chief of the Army Force, and we have telling them, I mean, you need to support the Constitution. You need to back the new president of Venezuela. You need to be on the side of the people who are suffering. And the majority of the soldiers, troops, they are with us because they are Venezuelans. They are suffering the same thing that ordinary people are suffering. So they know the reality. And at the end of the day, they will support what we are doing. They will support the change in Venezuela. And I don't have any doubt that the military, at the end of the day, will support what we are doing.
But as you know, the commanders of the military, the leadership of the military.
You mean the top?
The top of the military does still support Maduro and gets quite a lot of economic, diplomatic, political incentives from the government.
They are loyal until they aren't. That has been our history.
So how do you, what's the tipping point? Just how do you convince them not to be loyal?
I would say if we increase the level of pressure in these three different levels, you know, on the streets, from the National Assembly, from the international community, that will help to move also the military force to back what we are doing in Venezuela.
Much of the pressure, of course, has come from the U.S. Much of the support you receive has come from the U.S. Do you fear that gives Maduro a convenient excuse where he can say, look, it's the Yankees who are doing this, and that's part of the problem?
I would say that he's manipulating that. That is not the reality.
But is it not true that the U.S. is supporting you, supporting Guaido?
He has become an strong ally. But I would say that this is a movement led by Venezuelans under the leadership of Juan Guaido as an interim president. The people that you saw in that video, are they Americans? No, they are Venezuelans. Who was just talking before them? Trump? No, Juan Guaido. He's mobilizing the people. So this is the agenda which has been set by us. And of course, we are getting the support of the international community, and not only from the U.S., from the most important Latin American country, and also from the European country. So this is a fight between democracy and dictatorship. This is a fight between the free world and the regime of Maduro. So that's the way we see it. And I feel so proud to be a Venezuelan and a Latino, because the cause of Venezuela is taking place in our country because of the courage of our people. They're putting their life at risk right now, including Juan Guaido, in order to achieve our democracy. So we need to respect that. So, and I'm getting the support of the U.S., that's good. And it has become, as I said, an important ally on this. But, I mean, this is beyond the U.S.
Carlos Vecchio, recognized as the ambassador by this administration, thank you very much.
Thank you for this time.